Hi, I'm Olyanka. Today I'm going to show you the whole new range of professional artist brushes by Global. I've got all 23 of them. I'm going to open them, try them for the first time, do some samples and tell you my opinion about them. So let's get started.
To make it easier, I decided to divide brushes into 6 groups. First group is great for body painting and for bigger coverage areas. Second one is for flat and angled brushes, which are great for one strokes. Then round brushes for details. Then brushes for petals and swirls. Fifth group is blending brushes. And in the last group, there are special effect brushes, which you can use for different effects. Before I even opened the brushes, there were 4 things that I was really happy about. First thing that I loved about these brushes that they have plastic handles. This means that paint will never peel off and brushes will look much neater for longer time. Second is that the handles are rather short, so it's also easier to use when painting. Then third thing is the color. I love how vivid and bright they look in my kit. The last but not least thing is that the brush's end is tapered. Sharp end makes it so much easier to put brush in my kit when I'm in a hurry.
Before we start, please like, subscribe and click the bell button to know when I post. I make a variety of time lapses, makeup tutorials and product reviews. So if that's what you enjoy, this is the channel for you.
First brush is body painting brush. It is written that it's large size, so I'm not sure if there are going to be smaller ones later on. Application is very smooth and easy, really enjoyable to work with this brush. Then it goes kabuki medium size and kabuki small size. Kabuki brushes cover even more area than large body painting brush. The application of the paint is even softer and I would imagine that blending colors with this brush is very easy. These 3 brushes are amazing and I hope that Global will make another one a little bit smaller to make a perfect kit for body painting. These 3 brushes are the same size, they're 3/4 inch. The difference is in length and shape of bristles. Myself, I feel quite comfortable with all of them, so for me there is no difference in using them. Some people have certain preferences and they like one more than another. So this is what I noticed when painting. The first one is with flat, long bristles. I think painting with this brush is more flowy and it feels a bit softer. Short angle is easier to twist when you do the rounded objects like petals or butterfly wings. The only thing you always need to watch which side you load the paint. Short flat is a bit more precise than flat, but it holds less paint. Brushes are very comfortable to use, they are not too thick or not too thin. For now, in flat brushes there is only one size and I hope that Global will make some more like 5/8 and 1/2 inch sizes.
By the way, if you like one stroke technique or you would like to learn it, there is a Facebook group for you which is called One Stroke Beauty. You can find a lot of inspiration there or you can show your work. There is also a special chart for you at the top of the group where you can find artists who inspire the whole world with their one stroke designs. You can tick all the artists that inspire you or you can add your own one if they are not there.
There are 2 sizes of blending brushes, small and medium. Here I used a little bit of water and metallic paints to blend, but these brushes are good to blend with eyeshadows as well. Round brushes are great for line work, so I normally do outlines, do swirls and teardrops. Here I'm making a sample of each of the brushes, starting from size 6 to size 1. Then I do dots on the rubber and on my hand. Painting dots on real skin is so much different than painting on the board or on the rubber. Skin is much softer, so when I press, the dots are round. I love how springy the bristles are and they are kind of popping back straight away. And they follow the direction of your hand exactly as you plan.
The first brush petal full bloom is a little bit flatter than two other ones, but I would say that the effect is the same apart from its size. They're all great for double dip technique for painting petals and swirls. If you want to know more about double dip technique, you can check my videos where I tell loads of different ways of picking up the paint. I'll put the link to the video in the comments. The last category is special effects brushes. I put into this category all of the other brushes that they have and the ones that you can create different effects. I'm making a few strokes with each brush so you can see the brush strokes that these brushes can make and decide when you want to use it according to your own idea and imagination. At the end of this video, I will show an idea how I use them in a simple design. After the first try, I need to say that I didn't find any negative sides of these brushes. I like everything about them, and the only thing that I would like to happen is to have more sizes for flat and for body brushes. Thank you. if you are on Instagram, pop into one of my accounts and say hello. I do arts and crafts, face painting, creative makeup, and healthy food and travel. I hope to see you there.
This is all for today. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in my next videos. Bye!